Okay guys, very good morning to one and all present here. So this semester I'm going to take electrical machines 2 for your class. So you already studied about electrical machines 1 in previous semester. So this semester we have going for the electrical machines 2. That is a quick refresh of electrical machines 1. He is overall seeing about DC machines and the DC generators and transformers in electrical machines 1. But here in this electrical machines 2, you are going to discuss about AC machines. You are going to dealing with AC machines. So we will this class we can discuss about the introduction about the machines and what are the types of machines which is used in industries as well as domestics. So that and all we can discuss. So before we are going to discuss about the syllabus and thing, I just want to make you to know that what is a domestic appliances and what is the motors and that type of model used in this domestic applications. So I just want to make you to understand in your home, that means in fan what type of motor is used, similarly in grinder, mixer. So in these kind of applications, as electrical engineers, we should know what is the basic motors which is used there. Okay, that and all we will discuss now. Then we can go for the syllabus. What are the syllabus in electrical machines too? And we will see some basics of machines. Okay, so this is what we are going to discuss now in this session. So as you all know that ceiling fan. So since we are all electrical engineers, if someone is asking that what type of motor is used in the ceiling fans, so we're just blinking, right? So for that and all, I'm just giving some things like what is the motor which is used in ceiling fans and other applications, home applications and all. So first, generally ceiling fan is suspended from the ceiling and it circulates air in a room. That's the purpose. We all know that. So it is run in a single phase 220 volt AC supply. Why it is running in a single phase 220 volt AC supply is, so that is the clue. So there we are using motor is also single phase. Okay, that is why the fan is start to rotate in single phase. Okay, even in our home, some low voltages or some one phase is coming. So that time fan is running, but other equipment is not working. Right, so that's the case. So ceiling fans run on a single phase 220 volt AC, and usually the power consumption between 60 to 120 watts. So we know that even sometimes a bulb is coming 1000 watts and then 100 watts bulb, so like that is there. But fan is usually consumed 60 to 120 watts. So that depends upon the company of the fan. And the speed of the blade is around 200 rpm to 400 rpm. RPM means we know that revolutions per minute. So, okay, so here the question is, what kind of motor is used in ceiling fan is? Any guess? Yes. So, okay, we will discuss that is what kind of motor. That is ceiling fan. Another fan is stable fan. In that fan also, what kind of motor is used? So we should know about that. So, even ceiling fan, and then table fan, then exhaust fan, these are all located in industries. We all seen that while going for the industrial visits or some other industry areas, we will see these kind of fans, exhaust fans. Okay, so these things and all, they can use the single phase induction motors. Okay, so it also called as capacitor start or split phase induction motors. So usually, why they are choosing single phase induction motor compared to other motors is it's easy handling and easy repairing, simple design, even cost is also very low and efficient. So this is what. So we, as we are all electrical engineers, we should know about what kind of motors or what kind of machines which is used our domestic applications day to day life. So that thing and all we should know about that. Because these kind of questions will be asked in interview also. So you can prepare for that. Even gates and in the interviews, they will ask these kind of questions. Okay. So please focus on what kind of motors which is used in our domestic applications, even in our homes and some other things. So that's you should know about it as electrical engineers. Okay, so this is what